Yo, what's up, everybody? I want to welcome you guys back to my YouTube channel, Talk on a Hemi. If you can, smash that like button, hit that subscribe button. Let's get into it. So as you can tell by the title of this video, we have a little bit of an issue, and I've been kind of watching this issue for about a few weeks now. I just finally said, fuck it, I got to get this fixed. I just can't keep letting it happen. So the car does have an oil leak. It's not like where you guys think. It's kind of, and I mean, luckily I have the hiring on this car, or I would never, ever, ever be able to find this oil leak. But I'm gonna show you guys.
So what I'm talking about is you can already see the oil down here, right there, right here. There's more like right in there. You can see some, like just all in these little galleys here. And I think it's from my MDS plugs, or MSD, whatever those things are called. I think they're leaking, but I'm not too sure. But what I think would happen when I did the install on my camshaft, I damaged one of the O-rings on this. So I'm hoping the high rim makes for an easy install, honestly, because I can get up under there and probably pry these out pretty well. But I just got to remove this, remove the throttle body. I think I'm going to leave this on it. I don't feel like fucking with that. But I can just take the fuel, entire fuel rail off if I need to. But worst case scenario, I'll take the high ram off. It's not too hard to take off, but yeah. And another thing, in my oil catch can here, I got a whole lot of just gunk stored right there. So that's not good. I needed to get a fitting for this, and I've just been super lazy about it. So I'm going to swap this whole hose out here, make sure it's clean, and check this one over here too, the one that's going back to the motor inside of here. First thing I'm going to do is just go ahead and remove the throttle body, loosen up all these bolts. Nothing too bad here. Only four of them. Now that I got the throttle body and stuff out of the way and the motor's nice and cooled off, I'm just going to go ahead and clean up all this oil in these galleys here and double check everything, make sure everything's fine. Sorry this isn't like the best angle, but I'm really, really hoping that this right there, which y'all are looking at, I'll point to it right here. I really hope that's not a crack in my motor, and that's where the oil is coming from. Maybe it's just like a crack in the paint or something, but I'm really hoping it's one of these MDS plugs. Say worst case scenario, that is a crack in my block. I'm not even gonna lie, I would be pretty upset. The car would be down for a while, to be honest with you, because I'm getting a new truck here soon. I'm getting rid of the daily. I just got a new job for work, but a much better job, so that's gonna take up a lot of time probably, but I'm still gonna be producing content and all that stuff. But that's my next purchase, is getting a new truck. Something to haul the car around and get a car trailer. But after I get that truck, I think, because this is almost paid off, after I get the truck, I think maybe just throw a Hellcat motor in this. Not just your regular Hellcat swap. I'm going to like beef the shit out of it. It's going to be nasty. Even if the block's cracked. If it's not cracked, I'm leaving it as is. I'm not going to touch it. I might just throw a one piece on there. Maybe a one piece, some upgraded cooling and stuff on that, and I'm gonna call it a day because it's almost paid off. Maybe time to jump into something different. I don't know. And guys, I'll tell you what, this makes me feel a little bit better. I went to take this bolt off right here. Look at this. Better angle. This thing was not even tightened. It came loose. While I'm right here, I'm just probably gonna go ahead and swap it, just because makes me feel better. But damn it. Feel right there behind the damn water pump thing. Anyway, I'll get it in a minute. But that makes me feel a little bit better that that wasn't tightened down. I don't know how that didn't stay tightened, but look, I can just sit here and wiggle it out. So it's gonna make for probably a pretty easy removal. Get that area cleaned up a little bit and reseal that.
All right guys, so what's unfortunately probably gonna have to happen is I want to take the high ram off. Went ahead and took one of these off here. It's like the thing that holds the clip down with the screw. It just came completely off. It broke like the top of the this piece here off. I'll show you. It broke like this piece off right here that held this down. So yeah, I'm gonna have to drill it and get these out.
What I found actually here too is this gasket right here is like sticking out of the hole. So there's 100% oil getting by on that one. So now what I'm doing is I'm taking my high rim off. It's a little bit of a process. It's just not like a few bolts. You got to put these in, washers, and then I have some nuts right here to kind of hold all that stuff down there, so I don't want to lose all this. But yeah, that's what I'm doing right now. I got a few more to do, and then I should have this off. So what I'm thinking about doing is, if you get the high ram, it comes with these dumbass long bolts, and they hold, they just help secure the high ram. There's nothing different from this or a regular bolt with a nut on top of it or a screw or whatever. So I'm gonna take these, get the correct size the correct thread size. Sorry, I don't know why it's so fucking blurry.
So I get the correct thread size,
probably a bolt, I don't know, a little bit shorter than this maybe. It doesn't need to be too long, just something to get that, make the install a little bit easier on this.
I'm not trying to like knock Holly or anything like that. It's just like, damn man, why is this intake so hard to get on and get off? But it's not Holly's fault. It's, I gotta get this crossbar figured out. Like, I've already cut it once. I'm afraid if I cut it anymore, it's gonna collapse and just like break or something. Hell, I don't know, but I'll figure it out. But for now, I'm just gonna switch bolts. Go that route just to get something a little bit different, a little bit, make the install just a little bit easier, because they want you to thread and unthread these by hand, and it's just, it doesn't go smooth. It gets kind of hard.
So to show y'all what I'm talking about is, hold on, I have a bolt or a screw right here, whatever you want to call it, that just won't turn, and the instructions say don't put the screw into the head so far, blah blah blah, and I didn't do that. I put oil into the screws, they're still stuck. And you have to remove these by finger. So I'm just tired of like constantly twisting this stupid ass shit. I'm gonna just go get some real bolts and do it right, because I'm still struggling to get this off. I have a pair of vice grips. Probably ruined the threads on the bolt, but I don't care, I'm not reusing it. All right guys, so I got the last bolt here loose. This is the last one I needed to take off. Excuse me. So now we can go ahead and take the plenum off, screw it forward and lift up, and should be good. As the high rim's off, I'm gonna go ahead and clean up these ports just here a little bit. Nothing too crazy that I see. Everything looks really, really good and clean. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and take these plugs out. I'm gonna plug all these holes up, then I'm gonna run to the store and get some new bolts for these. All right, so before I remove this, I wanna show you guys what I'm kind of doing here. I don't know why it's not focusing, here we go. I've drilled a wood screw into the side of this. Now, this is how you take out the regular MDS plugs too. You just drill a wood screw in the side of this, and you take a hammer just like this. Let me see if I can get it on camera here. No, I'm gonna have to put the camera down. So this right here is what it's supposed to look like. I just drilled it down the side of it like that. But you can tell, I mean, look at the gasket on this thing. Like, this is the gasket on this one. This is a new one here, hold on. So yeah, much, much better. I think what happened was I damaged this on the install. So I'm gonna go ahead and just remove the rest of them, because I'm already in here, and get these put back in there, and then we'll go to the store. I'll show you this too while I'm here, because I already have it kind of halfway out. See if I can get it the rest of the way here. Yeah, it's coming out pretty easy. The gasket on it still just, it's junk, man. Like, it doesn't look very clean. Like, here. If it'll focus. I mean, that's the gasket. Obviously, there's definitely oil getting past it. So this back one was so loose that I just pulled it out with my hands. So that's not very good. I know they were tightened down. I'm guessing these gaskets, like, look, the gaskets just wore out on these things. All the MDS plugs are out. I'm gonna go ahead and run to the store, get a few bolts, maybe a few of the little miscellaneous things. Come back, get these plugs filled up, and then get the intake back on. Before we hit the road, I want you guys to go ahead and take a look at all these gaskets here. I mean, this is all four of them. I mean, they're literally, like, they was ready to fall apart. They was holding no oil back. They're just so fragile and just, I mean, I don't know. I'm glad I had the higher end so I could see this happening. If not, I don't know what I would have done.
So I went ahead and picked up the bolts, M6 by one. That's what they were. I think I'm going to have to reuse this long bolt, because I got a longer one here. I just don't think it's going to be long enough to get all the way down through the plenum and into that thread. So I might just have to reuse it.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put some engine assembly lube. I know that sounds crazy. I probably could just use oil, but I don't really have any laying around right now. I'm just going to throw some on the O-ring of this. That way it doesn't, like, rip or tear on the way when I just tap them in there. But these two back here, I mean, they're almost in with no issues. Like, this one right here is fine. This one, that one's probably good. But it's just these two up here that I'm a little worried about. So this is what I just threw on the sides of it. It's good for valve train and stuff. It's what I put on my cam for the cam swap. But I went ahead and got them all in there. I put them around these little top O-rings. And I took just, like, a socket like this right here, and just tapped super lightly down with the hammer just to get them down in there enough to where I can get the bolt started, and then it'll seal them the rest of the way up. So these are the new bolts so far. Honestly, I'm a huge fan. I think they look way better. They go on so much easier, man. Like, it's insane. I just still got to reuse this one for the tall one, but these other three right here, this shouldn't be a problem at all.
I got the plenum hooked up. Everything's torqued down properly. This is the torque that I used. The top ones here are 50 inch pounds, and then, like, the regular ones are 106, and then here's the,
I guess the sequence you go by, it's not too bad at all. But we got everything hooked back up. I want to go ahead and get the throttle body back on here, hook the intake up, and then start figuring out this oil catch can. And that's it. Everything's back together. Everything's hooked back up properly. Made sure all my fittings, like the fuel, my injectors, just really everything. Make sure everything is good, tight, double-checked everything before I can start this thing up. I don't want no leaks or anything like that. Seems to be running properly. The car sounds amazing. There's no leaks up by the MDS plugs, but whenever I go on a drive, that'll be the true teller. I'll go on one tonight. I gotta go to the gym and get a few things from the store. But let me be like a lesson learned. Just take your time and maybe put some oil or assembly lube around those gaskets on the plugs. Just make it for a super easy install. I don't think I put them on there last time. I think I just put them in there dry, hammered up in there, and then put the bolt down. Or maybe I didn't even hammer, maybe I just put the bolt in. I can't remember, but I did it right this time. I know these gaskets are much better quality and they'll hold up a lot better. So with that being said, I do appreciate you guys stopping by and checking out this video. If you can, smash that like button, hit that subscribe button. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.